know about you, but when I'm washing my face, I prefer to use some sort of like exfoliating scrub. You know, the kind with the little beads to make your face all squeaky clean? But those beads go somewhere after they're washed down the drain, and it's not good. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Microbeads feel great. I mean, my face just feels like $1 million after I give it a good scrub. Those tiny plastic beads are found in other products like soap and even toothpaste. But those beads wind up in the environment after we're done with them and can do some serious damage. And while a lot of plastic in the ocean comes from food products like plastic wrap and bottle caps, a lot of it is from these small microbeads. A recent study published in the journal Marine Pollution Bulletin found if millions of these beads get released into the water, the researchers estimate this could result in up to 80 tons of unnecessary microplastic waste. Because they're small and buoyant, they easily pass through sewage treatment plants. Basically, that's 8 trillion microbeads entering oceans and lakes every day, according to a study published in the journal Environmental Science and Technology. But that's just the beads that make it past the filters at treatment plants. Those that don't make it through wind up packed in with sludge. That's the very nasty mix of waste that's filtered out of wastewater. It's often used as, I hope you're not eating, but it's often used as fertilizer, so it's spread across fields. And nearly 800 trillion of these tiny beads are all trapped in it. And from there, some of those microbeads get caught up in runoff, and well, they wind up in the ocean, and they wind up in someone's stomach. And that's bad news. A study published in the journal Global Change Biology found that half of the ocean's turtles ingest plastic. Another study published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences found that 90% of seabirds have plastic in their stomachs, up from just 10% 30 years ago. Some researchers think that fish might mistake the beads for food, eat them, then mistakenly think they're full. Not to mention that plastic can poison the animals or lead to blockages in their intestines, both potentially deadly. And the microbeads and other microplastics can make things even worse. Despite their size, they can concentrate toxic chemicals already present in seawater. Basically, they act like little sponges that soak up toxins, which can accumulate in sea life and may be passed on to people. And it's not just microbeads, they're only a piece of a much larger problem. Researchers say there are 360,000 pieces of plastic for every square mile in most of the world's oceans. Another study published in the journal Science found that as many as 12.7 million metric tons of plastic find their way into the ocean every year. The most striking result of all this plastic pollution are giant trash gyres circulating in the surface of oceans. And when I say giant, I mean giant. The most infamous of which is the Great Pacific Garbage Patch. It's estimated to be twice the size of Texas, or some estimates say it's even the size of the US. Plastic doesn't biodegrade. Instead, things like microbeads or plastic bottles simply break into smaller and smaller pieces. Most of the Pacific Garbage Patch is made up of these tiny pieces of plastic, so you could be standing on a boat and it looks nothing like a landfill. Instead, these tiny pieces float right below the surface, making the water muddy and unclear. And all this microscopic plastic is doing some real damage to the inhabitants of those waters. So what do we do? Well, already there's legislation proposed. The Microbead Free Waters Act of 2015 was introduced into the House earlier this year. The aim of the bill is to ban cosmetics that contain synthetic plastic microbeads, beginning on January 1st, 2018. And even if the legislation doesn't go through, some companies have already agreed to replace those microbeads with more natural products. And even if we could ban microbeads, it still leaves a lot of plastic floating around. So researchers recommend that industrial countries take immediate action by reducing waste and curbing the growth of single-use plastic. Basically, you know the drill: reduce, reuse, and recycle. And stop using those face scrubs. Also, if you think biodegradable plastic might be an answer to our problems, think again. Here's a video from Trace explaining more.
Biodegradable plastics are the plastic industry's way of trying to remedy the pollution problem. But unfortunately for us, the term biodegradable is kind of convolutedly complex.
So what alternatives would you use? Apricot scrub? Coffee scrub? Let us know down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews so you don't miss a single episode.